What is up, guys, and welcome to another episode of the Top 10 Loadouts in TF2. Today, we're going to be taking a look at that slippery little bustin' maniac, the Scout. The first weapon in today's loadout is going to be the Mad Milk. This stuff will give you the edge in a lot of fights while also making you one of the most popular guys on the team. That's going to be backed up by our melee choice, the Atomizer, which will really allow the Scout to reach his maximum slippery potential. And finally, the main damage dealer in today's loadout is going to be the always trusty and reliable Scattergun. We're going to start by taking a look at the best ways to utilize each weapon in today's loadout. And then finally at the end, I really want to throw out some nice little tips for improving your accuracy when playing the Scout. Now, while we normally deal with primary weapons first, today we're going to begin by taking a look at the Mad Milk. The reason we're starting here is that the Mad Milk should always be used prior to actually engaging in a fight. As a Scout, fights will often be pretty short-lived, and with such low health, you can't afford to change to your milk, throw it, then switch back to the Scattergun in the middle of a fight, because by that time, you'll already be dead. Instead, aim to sneak up on enemies and throw the milk before they even know you're around. The incredible healing this item provides will really help give you the edge in a lot of difficult fights. While the milk is already fantastic when used alone, its potential as a team play item is really pretty incredible. Your team will heal 60% of the damage that they deal to a milked enemy. Compare that to something like the Conchatraw, which heals for only 35% of the damage dealt, and you can begin to see how amazing the milk really is. Throwing a jar of this stuff onto the cart in payload, in the middle of a big push, or to the point in cough while the enemy is trying to cap, will give your team a massive advantage in any fight. While slightly more situational, if it's used at the right time and in the right situation, the milk has equal, if not more power than items like the buff banner, and recharges much, much faster. And just as a bonus, the milk is also amazing for tracking down invisible and dead-ringer spies, as well as extinguishing yourself in a tight situation. Okay, let's take a look at the Atomizer. Understanding this weapon is pretty easy. It'll allow the Scout to jump an additional third time at the cost of 10 health every time you triple jump. As a Scout, your fast move speed and jumping abilities are one of the few things that'll keep you alive. The Atomizer really gives you some great survivability, as you'll be significantly harder to track down. While the 10 HP is a reasonable amount of health to lose, if you're using your triple jump to dodge a 100 damage rocket, then it was definitely worth it. Try jumping out into open spaces to dodge enemy explosives. This will make you almost immune to splash damage. Just don't forget to avoid triple jumping when you're under 10 HP. One final bonus of the Atomizer is the additional mobility can allow you to access some pretty cool places and appear in areas where the enemy would never expect you to be. Last, but certainly not least, let's take a look at our main damage dealer, the Scattergun. While at times in the past it's been eclipsed by unlocks such as the Shortstop and the Babyface Blaster, all those alternatives have been quickly nerfed by Valve, leaving the Scattergun as the almost uncontested king of Scout primaries. While the Scattergun is capable of putting out huge amounts of damage at close range, as you move into the medium to long ranges, it becomes extremely weak, and will only deal a fraction of its maximum damage. Because of this, try to avoid shooting enemies at a long range. While it can be really tempting to pull that trigger, patience is key when you're playing the Scout. Waiting that extra few seconds to sneak up on the enemy and get that massive 100 damage meat shot is really important. Shooting from a distance will deal a minuscule amount of damage and immediately lose the element of surprise, which is so important when you're playing the Scout. Now, if you're like me, the hardest bit about the Scout class is the whole aiming thing. I know, pretty important. So now I want to throw out a couple of quick little tips that might help you improve if you struggle a bit like I do. Now, many Scouts already do this, but it was something that I neglected for a long time, and while it won't immediately turn you into a pro, this small little mentality shift was a massive help to me. So naturally, I use quite a high sensitivity for rocket jumping. So for me, achieving that super precise mouse aim you need as a Scout is pretty damn hard. Because of that, I do very little aiming with my mouse, and instead I aim with my A and D keys. If you go back and watch this video again, you'll probably see that my aim stays quite still on the screen. Instead, I'll strafe left and right to scan over enemies and use that to aim instead. Unlike a mouse, strafing left and right is extremely reliable and consistent. While practice is still the best road to improvement, changing my focus from mouse aim to strafe aim really, really helped me, and I hope it can help you guys a bit as well. I really hope you guys enjoyed this episode of Top 10 Loadouts. Maybe leave the video a like if you did. Tell me what class you would like to see next week down in the comment section down below. And as always, I will see you legends in the next one. Bye-bye.